All right, so here's the start list for the women's 63 kilo A group. Sean, I was about to mention that in the history of this class, going back to 1997, no lifter from North or South America has found the medal stand in the total. And if you look at this group today, there are two very strong entries from Colombia who could put an end to that streak. But in their way, I think, is going to be that woman on screen right there, number 11, Laura Dana Thomas. So this is really a competition that is set up for a real battle. And as we go to the warm-up room now, let's take a look at our group. Here's Anni Vuohioki of Finland. She was a 2016 Olympian. She was 10th in Rio. Her best total is 201. She did that earlier this year when she finished 7th in split at the Europeans. Speaking of Europeans, here's Sarah Davies of Great Britain. She too was in split. She finished 5th there with a 208 kilo total. And now one of the two Colombians in this group, Lina Rivas. And Lina is a two-time Olympian. She was 7th in Rio, but at 58 kilos. You know, this is her third straight Worlds, and this is the first time we're seeing her move up to 58 kilos. So
this might
move up to 63 from 58.
Be because it's the year after the Olympics and not having her make weight. I don't know what she weighed. I don't know if we have that information. But
today, I would not know. Yeah. They no longer show it. All right, so now here's Wamaloon of Thailand. Another one who could get into this group, but she has less of a history, I would say, at the international level. And then here's a surprise ad, I guess you could call it, from Team USA. Now, Jessica Lucero was not a surprise ad to the world team.
That's correct.
But it was largely expected she would compete at 58 kilos. The original member of Team USA that was expected to lift in this group, unfortunately, Maddie Myers had to withdraw due to injury, so the decision was made to move Lucero up. Here's our lifter, Ching Mien Xin of Taipei. This is her last competition as a junior, but it looks like her third senior Worlds. Earlier this year in Tokyo, she was junior world champion. Oh, no, excuse me, at the junior Asian championship.
Asian champion.
Yeah. Kanye Yoshida of Japan. Looks like we do have body weights. Didn't know that. All right, and now here is Mercedes Perez, and I talk about the lifters of the Western Hemisphere who have a shot at being world champion here. She is the class of this class in regard to the Western Hemisphere. She's a two-time Olympian, finished 4th in Rio, and she's got a junior world championship to her label. We may be able to say senior soon.
Yes.
And now we're taking a look at Mitsuki. This is her first ever senior world championships. I think she was a late add for Team Japan. Now here's Win T Toi Mai. She's lifted quite a bit this year, but she's going to be a little bit of a wild card. She's been going through some rough streaks. Now we're back to Mitsuki. Starting to mention that she had been a late add. And then here is Maria Alemano of Italy. This is her third straight senior Worlds. She was 28th in Houston, but at 69, so she's actually dropped down a bodyweight class to be here.
It's going to be a competitive class. I mean, we have
one of the best lifters in the world in this class, that being Laura Dana Thoma, and she is the final lifter in this group. And right now, Thoma is sitting on the highest opening snatch, but I get a feeling there'll be some changes.
But we see, you know, a lot of not a lot of space in between the highest and the lowest snatches here.
And there are already changes going in the pack as our first lifter.
It's like back there, it's like a feeding frenzy when the stock market, when the bell starts and people start making trades. It's like that in the back room. And we have a good first attempt
from Kane Yoshida. 87 kilos. She did that as an opener early this year at the Japanese Championships.
Ooh, a little in front, but
at the same weight.
Doesn't matter as long as you make it.
That's right. That Japanese Championships was back in May. Kanye snatched 90 there, so let's see where she goes next. Now here's Sarah Davies of Great Britain. That is two meets in a row now where Davies has opened with 88 kilos. She did it at a meet in Great Britain, ultimately went to 91 and missed that on her second, but she looks sharp based on that opener.
Yes.
And if she continues moving like that, I think we'll be north of 91 by the time her series is over.
When everybody's packed this tight together, you really got to make lifts. You know, one miss can really put you behind. So it's important that these athletes come out and make their openers.
So here's Eri Mitsuke of Japan. This is the first time we're seeing her 88 kilos. Just once again, the weight on the bar.
Not a great attempt by her.
Where did you see, or what caught your eye?
Second attempt.
Behind it, maybe?
Just, I didn't seem like she extended to get the bar back. I mean, she caught it in a power. I mean, it was nearly a power snatch.
Almost parallel.
But it was out in front. I mean, it's odd to catch it that high and be out in front. So I'd like to see her finish and get that bar back.
So right now we are running a two-minute clock on Mitsuke. My guess is the Japanese coach walking away from the table after signing the table simply declared the weight.
Yeah, there's no way you go up after that.
Remember, after a miss, whether a lifter is following themselves or not,
number 10.
They're automatically assumed to be following themselves, or they're automatically assumed to repeat. But when there is two-minute clock running, they have until 30 seconds to make a declaration, and they can choose to make the declaration the weight that was automatically put on the card for them. If they don't make that declaration in the first 30 seconds, they're effectively locked onto that weight for the remainder of the clock they have to take. So by simply declaring it, which is a good practice to do, it gives her the option to move up if she wanted, but as mentioned, there was really no doubt that she would come out to take it here. So here she is back, Eri Mitsuke, with 88 kilos, second attempt.
That was better.
So at the moment, Jessica Lucero is on the board with 89 kilos. That's leaving her on deck, but I am being told she's already done 88 backstage. So look for that to move after Vuaki opens. And what I think is going to happen is if Vuaki...
She's moved up. Loaders, 89 kilos.
So wait for some changes here.
United States of America, this is Jessica Lucero.
You see on screen... Jessica Lucero is not there in that holding area, so she has moved up.
Jessica's best is...
Winte Tway Mai is now being called. Sorry, Sean, go ahead.
Jessica's best is it 92? 93?
Yoshida, be prepared.
It's American record 93.
Yeah,
she did it in Salt Lake last year at the Olympic trial. All right, so here is the lifter from Vietnam, first attempt, 89 kilos.
Waha. Nice save. Nice.
It was, and it was on the ledge, and it was an important lift for a very big reason.
Good lift.
Win T. Tway Mai has lifted at the Asian Championships and bombed out with 93 kilos. That was in November of last year, and she's lifted at the Asian Championships in April of this year, opened with 93 kilos and bombed out. So this is the first time she has made a snatch in her last, call it, seven attempts going back to the prior meet. So that is a very, very important lift for her there. And let's see where the string will take her. And now we are back to Annie Luioki of Finland.
Looks like she went over to her right side
at the pole or during the pole?
During the catch.
This
is strange.
Shifted over. Well, that left foot did come
this
forward.
Is the first something attempt from the United States of America, Jessica Lucero.
She looked like she, instead of being upright, you know, she was kind of pushing herself forward, which caused the balance shift. You really want to stay upright in the catch there. Put the balance right over the middle of the foot.
All right, so now here is Jessica Lucero. She is the U.S. record holder at 58 kilos with a 93-kilo personal best. Obviously did not have to cut weight today. Here she is opening with 90 kilos.
Surprised at that. You know, her training leading up to this was really good, really solid. She looked sharp. So I'm surprised that she missed that. Maybe a little bit of nerves, but I'm feeling she'll come back and do that. Yeah, I don't see. I mean, it was a good lift.
Yeah, I mean, it's right there.
Yeah, she did everything right except make it, which.
So she will get a little bit of a rest here at 90 kilos. That weight is going to stay on, but will now bring out the only junior lifter in this A session, Qing Yanxin of Chinese Taipei. She has snatched over 100 kilos in her career. She did that earlier this year.
At 63.
No lift, and I'm not sure if you can tell at home, but it sounds like the 30-second clock is stuck. And while Mian Xin was on stage, that sound is still buzzing.
Yeah.
In the arena, and I wonder if that's a distraction. I wonder what they're doing here. One referee is out of her seat. The lifter is on the stage.
Well, I'm distracted, JP, so I can't imagine the lifters. I can imagine the lifters will be, too.
Just letting it go. Well, Alemano is not distracted. And the second she celebrated there, the sound went off. No.
No. Still going.
Loaders, 90
they're going to have to figure this out.
We're going to call now.
But it looks like they're going to make
Yoshida,
the competition
Japan.
Continue. And, you know,
attempt.
These lifters are pros. They are the best in the world. And they're just going to have to deal with it, I guess. It's a great reaction.
Yeah, that wins the best reaction award for the week so far.
Oh, we could still see some fun stuff. Hang on. Wait. There's some flair in this class.
Well, Fernando Reyes is lifting. He's always good for something.
Well, that's later on, yeah. All right, so now here's Kanye Yoshida, 90 kilos, second attempt, made 87 on her opener.
Oh, boy, it looks like it's out way out in front, but maybe that's
but
her.
It's not.
But it's not, right.
Good lift. 90 kilos.
Two for two. Take a look
two.
At this, and maybe you'll see where she punches out. And,
Loaders, 90 kilos. We're going to call from Finland, second attempt, Vuijoki.
Can't really tell.
From there, but yeah, you were genuinely surprised when you saw the punch out. All right, so now Uyoki is back for her second attempt. She missed her opener with 90.
She has to stay upright to catch. Bar, shoulder, hip, middle of the foot, all in a line.
90 went behind her. Now it's fine.
That's, you know, it's not uncommon to see that kind of overcompensation. You know, you miss one behind, and then the next one you don't get.
Say it all the time. Absolutely, it just.
United States of America.
Which means this next one will be right in the middle.
We hope so, and here's the reason why. Uyoki, who was in the 2015 World Championships, bombed out in the snatch. So,
oh boy.
World Championships on U.S. soil have not been kind to her thus far. And hopefully she can dance the dance and avoid a bomb out in her second straight World Championships. We'll find out in a moment. She is currently on deck. And now we will go back to Ching Nian Shin of Chinese Taipei. A couple of months ago at the Universiade, she took a crack at that 101. She snatched 97. She made 101 at the Asian Championships. But she's on a second attempt here after missing 90.
Again, you know, these athletes might not be peaked for this because the beginning of the quad.
Give you another reason in a second.
No lift for G at 90 kilos.
All right, so let's take a look at this again.
We're going to call.
Tell me what you see here, Sean.
Finland. This is attempt number three.
You know, I think it was exactly in the right spot, just not secured overhead. So she got it there where it needed to be, and then it just drifted.
Well, she, in a moment, will be in the same do-or-die situation that Uyoki is now currently in with 90 kilos. And for the first time, we're really starting to feel the energy of the audience here, and this is something you want to see.
Well,
frankly, here.
Yeah. Well, there's a fire under her butt now. She's got to make it happen.
She has made it happen. Any Uyoki of Finland will move on to the clean jerk.
Too little excited to slid down the stairs.
It's all right. You can miss a stair, not the lift.
Right, exactly.
I'll take it.
And she did exactly what she had to do. She made the adjustment.
This is her third and final attempt.
You know, it just being on this stage at this meet is very different than anything else, other than the Olympics, of course. And it's you can't simulate it. You can't simulate how it feels to be up there. And no matter how well your training goes, how well the it looks in the back, it's a different ball game up
right.
on that platform.
Well, the situation is the same.
Yes.
Right now, for our lifter from Chinese Taipei, she has missed 90 on her first and second attempt. So Ching Nian Shin must make this to stay in the competition.
Yes.
And she has.
Good lift. Good comeback.
Just tough. You know, she doesn't look thrilled, I know, but. But that's world class.
Right.
Sarah Davis, Great Britain.
So hard to come back there.
And just what a straight line. Marston's right on the body.
Yeah, it's great. Great lift.
All right, so now it looks like we are back to, is it Davies? Oh, Lucero moved. So 91 kilos, Jessica has moved up to 91 kilos. Sarah Davies also is looking for 91 kilos. She opened with 88, and as mentioned, the last time she was at Worlds, she snatched 89. Her last meet, she snatched 91. On her third, she missed this on a second attempt.
Oh.
Just couldn't stop the momentum.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, she's getting the bar in the right spot. You just got to slow it down. You got to stop it once it gets there. Bar maybe came away a little bit. Yeah,
Lord came away a little bit at the top, and it never stopped. It just that
right.
Even while she was underneath it, it just. All right, so she will be back for her third attempt.
David, Great Britain next.
And now we have Jessica Lucero for her second attempt. Jessica opened with 90, missed it, and elected to move up 1 kilo.
I'd like to know why. I mean, she didn't need the time.
Did get her a four attempt or so rest. Not too bad.
She missed the same exact way she missed that first one.
And that one was actually a little further away.
Right.
It was more in front.
From Great Britain, Sarah Davis, third and final attempt. Lucero next.
And
at the same weight.
You mentioned, Sean, that she's had a good
91 kilos is the weight.
Training cycle
really
leading into this. So
from United States of America,
hopefully.
Jessica Lucero.
She can
as the clock ran on Davis,
come through here on this third attempt, because now she is the third lifter
right.
Staring down the barrel of a, you know, bomb out gun. So,
you know, one thing I'll say, over the last couple of years, Jessica has proved to be a fantastic pressure performer.
Well, she is under pressure because she just had her 2 minute clock burned as well. So now she has to come right back out here. That's a savage play from Sarah Davies.
Well, Sarah Davies' team made the right call.
It's the right call. So now here's Jessica. Here's Jessica Lucero. Third attempt, 91 kilos. Must make this to stay in the competition.
That's too bad. I'm surprised that she missed that. I mean, again, she's been such a clutch performer.
So Jessica Lucero has bombed out. If you see this lift, the bar looks a little bit away from her right at the start. I think it was in front of her the whole way. And all three of them are the same. And this will be interesting now to see how she handles and what she decides to do in the clean and jerk.
I'd really like to see her come out clean.
Absolutely. But we'll see the approach. So now, Retinwan Wamalun of Thailand. This is her first attempt. 92 kilos.
Beautiful.
This is the first time we're seeing Wamalun at a major international competition, but this is not the first time we're seeing technique like this from a lifter from Thailand.
Right.
Let me just watch this.
Very well coached. Nothing, you know, it's really efficient. There's no wasted movement. It's just exactly enough to make the lift.
Yeah, and it may not be the fastest thing you've ever seen. It may not be
fast enough.
Well, but what I'm saying is your point is that it's just right.
Yes, exactly.
So now here's Eri Mitsuke of Japan, 92 kilos, third attempt. This is a 4 kilo increase from her second attempt success with 88 kilos.
Hold it. Oh. Boy, those are the worst.
Yeah.
Those are the worst.
I mean, it's a plane crash on a landing, right? You got through the whole flight.
So that's an actual, it's a good analogy.
And what happened, unfortunately, if you saw it right as she was about to complete, you know, getting into a standing position, her lower back, I think, just arched backwards and she lost it forward. All right, so now here is the second lifter from Japan, Akane Yoshida, and this is her third attempt thus far, 2 for 2. 2 kilo increase. That was crazy
great.
For like four different reasons.
That was great.
3 for 3 Yoshida. For Akane Yoshida. And just take a look at this. I mean,
Loaders, we need more now.
You couldn't put a piece of paper underneath the bottom position. And she knows that she was down in that hole.
That's
a great lift.
Cards ready. Alemano, second and third.
All right, so now here is Alemano. Opened with 90, made it.
And she's fired up. Yeah.
Yes, she is. And she's making lifts.
I don't think she stopped moving. From the time that she walked onto the stage, lifted, and then went off, it just kept on moving.
It's always fun when you see a lifter know they've made it when they hit the bottom position. And that's exactly like her reaction when she hit bottom. She knew she had it.
But you have to be careful
you do.
With that.
Yes. But when it works out, it's fun.
Yes.
All right, so now Sarah Davies of Great Britain missed 91 on her second attempt, has moved up to 93. And this is if she wants to swing in the top five, and if things go her way, this is a crucial lift. And this will drop her back to 88 if she misses, so.
Yeah, I think that bar is just rotating into the receiving position.
Right at the top of the transition, though, right?
Yeah, it's just really difficult to stop it once it's moving.
But that loop happens right there.
Right there, and then it's just, you got it. I mean, she still had an opportunity to
stop.
She
almost fought it back. She just couldn't. In terms of the flow of that lift, the look of that lift, and the movement, it looked no different than the 91.
No.
All right, so now looks like Lena Rivas will change. And we either have a change or something completely out of control.
In that, 95 kilos still the weight.
I'm still looking at it twice to make sure I'm not nuts. But Nguyen Thi Thuy Mai of Vietnam has moved from 89 kilos to 103 kilos. So what she's doing is waiting to drop down.
Yeah, so she's really.
There's no way she's thinking.
She thinks she can beat everybody. And just is waiting to see what everybody else is doing.
All right, so now we're back to Alemano, who has taken a 2 kilo jump. She's going to save the celebration on this one for off stage, but
that's right.
What a series for Maria Alemano. And on all three of her attempts, the rebound, she wastes no time down in that bottom position.
You know it's in the right position when you come right out.
Yeah.
Because if it's not in the right position, you have to fight in the bottom there and you stay down there for a little bit. But when it's in the right position, you come right up.
So now here is Wamaloon, 96 kilos, second attempt.
Ooh, good.
Good lift, but you see the contrast in style, and you see this a lot with a lot of the Thai lifters where they will pull the bar very smoothly, secure it in the bottom position, and then come up very controlled, right? And that's kind of what you got right here in this lift.
First attempt. To be followed by Wamaloon.
Controlled all the way.
And that's my preference. So when I teach the snatch to people, I want them to control it and then stand.
Because it's repeatable? It's more consistent?
More consistent.
Okay. All right, so now here is Mercedes Perez of Colombia. And I was about to say she's intense.
Well, you're absolutely correct.
Almost. And she's fired up.
That is good and clear.
Rompian hielo.
98 kilos, please. The automatic.
Well, she might be taking the title of best celebration.
Oh, wait, Maria. We're not done.
Third attempt in the same weight.
But that's just starting her off, and her best ever is 105, so I think we'll probably see something in that 100-101 range. And with five lifters remaining, including her, you're now in that spot of any miss can cost you a medal. So she has, I think, of this top four, if you want to call it that, has opened first, but we'll see how the game plays from here. This is Wamaloon's third attempt, 98 kilos. And Wamaloon has at least listed a very big clean and jerk opener. So this is somebody who's electing to stay within themselves and in their abilities and not get trapped in that competition for a medal in the snatch. So a conservative play here from the lifter from Thailand.
Beautiful. Wow. Really nice.
And if she winds up on the medal stand later, it's because of the discipline and the decision to play the game her way here in the snatch. So let's see how it goes in just three smooth and excellent lifts from Wamaloon. Don't forget, that only puts her in second right now.
Right.
All right, so now here is Lena Rivas.
Stars ready. Rivas, 101 kilos. Perez, get ready.
Leo!
First time we're seeing Rivas at 62 kilos.
Se puede, Rivas.
Loaders,
101 kilo opener.
We're going to call her countrymate from Colombia, Mercedes Perez, second attempt.
And over the course of Lena's career, she has been always very solid in her opener, but I have never seen her open. I'm sorry, in the Olympics in 2012 was the only time she's opened with 100 or more, so we're going back away.
¿Qué te gusta?
No lift there.
Looks like she squeezed the bar real hard. Didn't get that speed in the arm and the turnaround.
Off when she started the lift?
No. When she started to transition onto the bar.
Mercedes Perez, Colombia. This will be her third and final attempt.
Tough to tell.
All right, so now 101 kilos is going to stay on the bar for Mercedes Perez, and she's got a decision to make here. She's going to have to follow herself if she wants to do this.
She absolutely should, because or else she's going to put herself in a hole in the clean and jerk.
And there's a wrinkle in that. Yesterday in the B session, Mo Sharon of Canada, who absolutely should be lifting right now, crushed 102 on her second attempt, on her third attempt, and that is the lead right now. So 101 will move Perez into second place. And 103, where three lifters are sitting right now, would ultimately be the leader. So there's a good chance we see a medal out of the B. It's
right.
a possibility if things go wrong here or go south for the lifters who are remaining. So right now, 101 kilos is going to stay. Mercedes Perez is going to stay with it and follow herself here. Good comeback.
Nice. That was a good lift. That was a good comeback. She's an experienced lift.
Oh, yes, she is. Two Olympics under her belt, couple of worlds, several Pan Ams.
Calling for 103 kilos for their next attempt. This is Loredana Elena Toma, Romania, first attempt.
All right, so the only lifter we have yet to see is Loredana Toma of Romania until now. She's out with 103. She had originally been slated for 105. She waited up high and dropped, you know, down to a weight that would move her into the lead.
Oh, beautiful.
What do you even say about that?
Yeah, I mean, that's just perfect.
103 kilos.
So we want to talk about our lifter for Vietnam.
Yeah, so, well, let's take a look at the replay here for Toma. Just that pull.
I mean, that's just perfect.
Toma to follow. 104 kilos.
So the lifter that we thought had moved from 89 to 103, I don't even know what's going on with
well,
that.
Well, I would imagine it was an injury in the back and they were trying to buy some time.
So Nguyen has withdrawn from the competition, so the lifter from Vietnam is out.
Which is a big deal because she was one of the favorites.
She potentially, yeah, she was in the mix here.
So now that's going to open up, it's going to open up a space for somebody else to sneak in there and win a medal.
So now we are back to Lena Rivas, who needs 104 to move into the lead. And with that move from Nguyen, by the way, Maud Sharon of Canada is guaranteed at least a bronze. Oh.
No lift for Rivas at 104 kilos. We're going to stay with 104 kilos.
All right, so now
we're gonna call once again, Lena Rivas.
104 stays on, and what do you
third
do here? Well, let's take a look at this.
You got to stay there. Because the battle's in the clean and jerk, and they're all
agreed.
They're all around the same.
And at the moment, yeah, with which the jockeying and the changes occur. But here's how you lay it out, and what'll happen is 104 is what will put you into the lead, okay? And Loredana Toma has elected 106. If Rivas comes out to take this 104, what's going to happen is while she's on the platform, I think Toma will drop down to 105. And on screen right now, we have Maud Sharon, who is just figuring out from the audience that she's going to be on stage in a little bit to take a medal.
Congratulations.
So Maud Sharon of Canada has won a bronze in the snatch from the B session. We see it every now and again, but I think that was a candid shot of her just finding out about it.
Yes, I think that was a perfect a perfect timing.
All right, so now here is Lena Rivas of Colombia to move into the lead. What did you see it forward?
I saw it right away. It was out
off the floor.
Yeah, the whole thing was forward.
No lift. Rivas, 104 kilos.
It's odd. I've seen her lift before.
Kilos now.
She didn't look like this.
This is for the second
all right, so there's a couple of things
Loredana
here. Let's take a look at this.
Elena Toma, Romania.
Can't really tell from here.
But it It just looks like a good slot, but what you're saying is when you saw it off the floor, her body.
I said as soon as it started moving, I knew he was going to miss it.
Okay, so with that miss, Mode Sharon sitting in the crowd is going to have to walk to the other side of the stage because she is now the silver medalist in the snatch from the B session. That means Rivas is going to be the bronze medalist, and Toma has already won the gold in the snatch competition.
And Mode is in the actual position to medal in the total, too.
Hang on. Yeah, that's good. So now 106 for Loredana Toma of Romania.
And there's no reason to believe that she's going to miss this the way she looked on that opener, 103.
Man. That would be a correct assessment.
I don't know if that takes a lot of brains to figure that one out, but...
Loaders more. Let's try.
That was fantastic. She's really well coached.
That's a layup, Sean. I will opt not to take.
But I will say this.
Just great.
I mean, the timing of the catch wasn't great, but this is a great example of being rigid at the bottom and not letting it drift.
Right.
Because if she wasn't rigid, that bar would have gone behind. Because like I said, she beat the bar to the bottom and it crashed on it a little bit.
But because there was no swing.
There was no swing, and there was no give in the elbow or the shoulder.
So that's two for two for Loredana Toma. 107 kilos is the automatic increase. We're gonna see a couple of changes here. Toma, from what I can tell, has attempted 110 in the past, did not make it. That was back in 2016. In split earlier this year, she tried 104 twice, so she's already, she missed them. So she's already taken
it. Well, she declared 109, then went down to 108.
Which you can, no. You could do that as long as it.
No, I know, but
it was never introduced.
But it's just odd. She's not battling with anybody now.
Well, yeah, and it could also be that. Let's see if we can see what it looks like.
109, yes.
They may have accidentally. I don't know. Whatever.
She doesn't have to take any chances because she's in a good spot here. I don't think she's going to be challenged for total medal.
Right.
So she's going to have. Oh, now we're back to 109.
Hang on that, actually. Hang on that. One thing of note here before Toma comes out, actually, Win of Vietnam declined her second and third snatch attempts. She has not withdrawn from the competition, so she will be back to clean and jerk. So Loredana Toma will take 109 kilos here on her third attempt. 3 kilo jumps throughout this series.
Why not?
Sure, and they've looked great. You know, and as mentioned, she has attempted 110. So if successful, we have to believe this will be a personal best for Toma.
Now she's got to get the timing right in the catch. Although as perfect as it's been, that could come back and bite her. That was perfect. Now that was perfect timing.
This might very well be Loredana Toma's day.
Well, I have to say, oh, Canada. Good job.
Well, let's take a look at this again.
Perfect.
Well, maybe she just needed a little more weight.
Right. That's all you need.
All right, so with that, we have concluded our snatch competition in the women's 63-kilo Group A session. There is our winner, Loredana Toma of Romania.
Well done.
3-for-3 series, 109-kilo snatch on her third attempt. Our silver medalist, Mode Sharon, is out in the audience watching attentively to see if she can perhaps medal again.
I wonder if that takes the fun out of it.
Not at all. She looks pretty pleased right now.
Right. I would imagine she's very pleased.
Yeah. And then our third medalist, who I would imagine is somewhat disappointed at the moment, Lena Rivas, with a 101-kilo opener. She will be, I think, still in play for a clean and jerk medal, definitely. But yeah, now this is a 10-kilo This is a 10-kilo separation.
And she put herself in a bad spot. She had control over her placement, and she didn't make the lift.
Well, and they were close attempts. Sometimes that happens, you know. Not every day could be great. But ultimately, Tolma delivered, and, you know, she has really separated the field. But when you start talking about these middle to light heavyweight weight classes, a 10-kilo deficit from the snatch to the clean and jerk is not a guaranteed win. And we're going to see how it shakes out. So Mo Charon is the leader right now with 224.
And I think she's studying to be a police officer.
Is she?
Yeah, I believe so. I spoke with her at Pan Am's last Pan Am's, I think.
So here are the results of the snatch on screen, our women's 63-kilo results from the snatch competition. Mode one more time. And here's her performance from yesterday. And if you look at it again, there was that little hitch in the right arm there, and you couldn't see it on the screen, and it doesn't matter because it's official.
Right.
But Jerry can't look at it now. It's a good lift. So that 102-kilo effort from Charon is a silver medal. And this could really add another wrinkle. And I wonder, as we head into the clean and jerk, how aware the coaches are. And we've seen some errors. It is their job to know that Mode has done 224. And, you know, 224 total.
Sorry.
Yeah,
right.
Clean and jerk is 122. But, you know, we have seen some coaching hiccups over the course of the first few days of competition here at the 2017 Worlds. So game is on.
Right.
We'll be back with the clean and jerks in just a bit.